Welcome to WebStylePress. Once upon a time, my manager asked me to create a toggle functionality. I created it right away like this. He duplicated the HTML block and then we had this. Now this is not correct. Only clicked block should be toggled and not the other. This is because we targeted generic classes and did not took into consideration which block was triggered. There should be a control to identify which block was triggered and only that block should be toggled. We are fixing this in this tutorial. This tip is not just for toggle. Whenever you create something, make sure you keep in mind that there may be copies of that code block. For example, you may need more than one toggle or accordion or something like that on a single page. Only that thing should respond to click that was triggered and not its copies or duplicates. This is a very important lesson. Make a note, try it, practice it, apply it. Okay, this is our HTML. A CSS file is linked with it, custom.css. Bootstrap is also linked with it via CDN.js. Then we have got custom.js linked with it at the end. And we have got jQuery linked via CDN.js. Here in our code block, toggle wrap is the outer class for the card. Toggle trigger will be clickable header for the card. It's also the title for the card. Toggle area is the area that we want to toggle. This whole area. We will need some basic CSS styles like toggle trigger. We will use cursor pointer and font weight bold. Then we will use some margin bottom for our columns. And this is our JS file. Inside our document.ready, when DOM will be ready, we will call a function. Let's name it toggle. Below this call, we will write this function and its functionality. So if we click at toggle trigger, this area, this toggle area should toggle. Toggle trigger, click function. E. Prevent default. We are preventing default in case we want to use anchor element for title. In case of anchor, it will stop page reload. And then we have got toggle area dot slide toggle. You can use toggle or slide toggle. Save, refresh, and here we have got it. Now both areas are being toggled, so we will modify our code. So add click of this toggle trigger, this will hold this clicked title. This dot closest dot toggle wrap. Toggle trigger dot closest toggle wrap. Toggle trigger, and its closest is this toggle wrap. Dot find, and it should find this toggle area inside it. Dot slide toggle. Save. Refresh. Now this is good. When we click at toggle trigger, this is toggle trigger by using this keyword, we get only that element which was clicked. Then we grab its closest outer element, that is toggle wrap. This one. And we find toggle area inside it. And we toggle it. It will not affect other similar element at that page. Only current block of code will respond to this technique. And this is how you overcome this issue. By using this technique, you can code the functionality once and apply it for multiple elements at same page without conflict. So remember this closest, dot closest, and dot find in jQuery. Instead of targeting generic classes, use this keyword and then dot closest and then dot find to target specific area. Alright, give this video a like, subscribe to the channel and press bell icon. Stay tuned and I will see you in the next video.